Colleen is the number one femme fatale in Pine Valley, and she is. Then Tad Martin is certainly the number one lady killer. The hottest guy in town, he drove every girl and her mother crazy. And Tad the Cad loved them and left them all. Until Sweet Hillary Wilson captured his heart. But by then, Dottie Thornton had captured him.
I'm pregnant. And your baby.
Repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
And with all my worldly goods, I thee endow.
With all my worldly goods, I thee endow.
By the power vested in me by the laws of this state, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Tad wasn't about to live unhappily ever after, and after all, he did have another lady in waiting.
Mr. Martin, is he here yet?
No, he's not. I was hoping maybe you would have heard something.
I gotta go get the keys from the desk, okay? Did you get that?
Hey! Hey! Son of a... You lost yourself! You lost yourself!
The man has just flown the coop.
Oh, he has not.
Of course he has. Now, you know there is nothing in the world that would keep Tad from his own wedding.
Really? Well, here's the proof. We are all here, and where is he? Obviously, we've all been fooled. We've just been taken in by his apparent change in behavior. But he is still the same irresponsible scoundrel he's always been.
Oh, that is not true. Okay, that's it. I'm going to prove you're wrong, and I'm going to become Tad's wife today. This is the last thing I'm...
Hillary, wait, you just leave her alone.
Is she all dead?
Mom,
is she dead?
Shut up, Mom. Hillary, it's Dottie. Are you okay? Hillary,
are you all right? What's going on?
You scared me half to death. Why did you run in front of my car?
You are so lucky that my mother stopped. Come on, are you all right?
I don't know. Miss Ferguson, please, you have got to take me to the bank. Tad did not show up at the church, and I've got to find him at the bank. Please.
Well, why do you seem so surprised? We tried to tell you about him, but you wouldn't listen.
Shut up! I want to go to the bank!
This woman to be your wife, to love together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Hillary, will you have this man to be your husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my devotion, my respect, and my continuing love.
And I promise to share all life's hopes and happiness and its triumphs, its failures, its joys and sorrows, and all else that life shall hold before us.
What God has joined together, let no one put asunder. For as much as Hillary and Tad have declared their love for each other before this company by taking solemn vows, and by giving and receiving rings, I now pronounce that they are husband and one. You may kiss the bride.
Sometimes love doesn't last forever. Sometimes you fall in love again. And sometimes it happens between friends. And Tad was the best friend that Dixie Cooney ever had.
I've never felt this way before.
Okay. Let me ask you a couple questions. Do you feel like you can't catch your breath? You feel like your arms and your legs are made of jello? And you think you're just about to fall?
Yeah.
And you know that no matter how far you fall, you're never going to hit the ground. But you're just so far above it. And you just keep getting higher and higher and higher. And you're afraid you're never going to come down.
Yeah. Yeah, that's it exactly. What? What?
It's never occurred to you, has it?
No, what? What are you talking about?
You're in love with me.
No. No, no, that can't be.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow. And with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you in the name of God.
Ted, I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow. And with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you in the name of God.
Now that Tad and Dixie have given themselves to each other by solemn vows, through the joining of hands and through the exchange of rings, I pronounce that they are husband and wife. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Those whom God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. Amen. You may kiss the bride.
Many beautiful weddings. If only we could stay married as much as we get married. But not every wedding ends in divorce. As Erica found out a few years, a few husbands, a fiancé or two later.
You belong in an asylum.
Well, I may be the Mad Hatter, but you're still my legal wife. You see, Stuart took my place at those sad proceedings. So you may be divorced from him, but you're still married to me.
No.
Yes. It's amazing, isn't it? 5 minutes ago, you were an abandoned woman, and here you are, Mrs. Adam Chandler. Ain't life grand?
Oh, why? Why is my life never simple?
Will you have this man to be your wedded husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health? And forsaking all others, keep you only unto him as long as you both shall live.
I will.
The ring, please.
The ring.
The ring, yes.
Now repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed, Erica.
With this ring, I thee wed, Erica.
Inasmuch as Adam and Erica have consented together in holy matrimony, I now pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss your bride.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much, Reverend. Oh, you did a splendid job of officiating.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much. What's so great about a limo?
Well, I have a driver ready to whisk you away to the airport.
Are you in your mind? Are you really some sort of a brainless fool? You don't really expect me to go on a honeymoon with you.
Well, we are newlyweds.
Oh, you really are an unspeakable pig, aren't you? Adam, once again I have to refer to our agreement, and it states very clearly, right above your signature, no marital rights, none, None for the duration of this marriage made in hell. So you touch me, breathe on me, and I'll kill you.
Erica was so much happier at her next wedding to Dimitri Mara.
I, Erica, take you, Dimitri, to be my husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Until we are parted by death. This is my song.
As long as we keep falling in love in Pine Valley, there will always be weddings to look forward to.
Ring. With this ring I be wed.
And with all my worldly goods, I be endowed.
With all my worldly goods, I be endowed.
By the power vested in me, by the laws of this state, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
But Tad wasn't about to live unhappily ever after, and after all, he did have another lady in waiting.
Martin, is he here yet?
No.
If Erica Kane is the number one femme fatale in Pine Valley, and she is, then Tad Martin is certainly the number one lady killer. The hottest guy in town, he drove every girl and her mother crazy. And Tad the Cad loved them and left them all. Until Sweet...
There's not. I was hoping maybe you would have heard something.
I gotta go get the keys from the desk, okay? Did you get that?
The man has just flown the coop.
Oh, he has not.
Of course he has. Now, you know there is nothing in the world that would keep Tad from his own wedding.
Harry Wesson captured his heart. But by then, Dottie Thornton had captured him.
I'm pregnant. And your baby.
Repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed.